This is a tough sutra to interpret and understand. Or by knowledge of dream and sleep, to attain clarity. Or else the mind can be made steady by giving it the knowledge of dream and sleep for support. As practitioners, you realize that your sleep is quite light, right? That you, in the beginning, we could have misunderstood that we are having some sleeping disorder. We may have misunderstood. And then over a period of time, we have been having a very complex relationship with our sleep. Sometimes seems to be good, sometimes seems to be not so. And then over a period of time, you may feel that you are not sleeping. And then when you wake up in the morning, you feel that you have grown internally, knowledge-wise, intellectually, spiritually, you have grown. Then, how to understand this feeling that every time you go to sleep, that wakeful state, many divisions of life has to be managed, but sleep seems to be very exclusive in self-development, almost like when we invest our time in the practice of yoga. When we invest the time in the practice of yoga, it's exclusive. No other processes are taking place. Not like in the arena of the mind where there are so many things that needs to be shared with. In sadhana, it's very exclusive. Then eventually it feels like sleep itself is very exclusive process of attaining clarity and knowledge. The waking up feels that you have grown in wisdom, in your inner knowledge. So this is what Patanjali says, that or else the mind can be made steady by giving it the knowledge of dream and sleep for support. That sleep becomes a process of prolonged yoga nidra. When we are doing the yoga nidra, it is technique, isn't it? It's technique of self-development. We are not allowing ourselves to completely drop into sleep, nor are we fully awake. We are in the mid-path, in between sleep and wakeful state. That is for about 15 minutes. Those days, if you remember, we used to do for 45 minutes. But we have another opportunity. That is the 5 hours of sleep which you take every day. Now your face all changing a bit. Okay, now 8 hours. 6 hours. How many hours is healthy sleep? For normal bodies and minds which are engaged in activities in daily life without any form of practice of self-development. I'm not talking about physical exercise, I'm talking about the whole works of sadhana. Pranayama, kriya, the shatkarmas. Then it could be very easily managed with 5 hours. 5 and a half hours or 6. No need more than that. But for a body and mind which has no sadhana to fall back to, then it is alright to have 8 hours. So therefore we don't judge anyone who is sleeping 8 to 9 or 10 hours a day, because they may need it due to the lack of other practices. We do pranayama, when we do the asanas, we oxygenate well. We ventilate the brain and other cells well. Whereas some other individuals who are not practicing may not have. The same thing when they change the diet. For you, when you change your diet, you don't feel such a great force influencing your energy levels, because you are able to maintain. For example, from a very high meat diet, you shift to fruit and water and vegetable diet. Many people say that they feel weak and all that, but you don't feel this because the sadhana and this kind of diet goes well together. So you feel it is such a nice environment internally when you combine this. Others may not. So the laws that govern a practitioner, the natural laws that govern a practitioner, seems to be different from the laws that govern a non-practitioner. And we have to view this in compassion. That your view has to be very compassionate, not judgmental, nor forcing anyone to follow this path, saying that I feel so wonderful, there is so much of progress in my mind and my consciousness due to this diet, due to these practices. No, we are not going to do that to anyone, because they may not be able to understand nor follow this. Therefore, we give our greatest compassion during those moments. There seems to be a solo journey, but eventually everyone will reach that. If energy is always changing, and it is not death, energy does not die, it's always changing in different forms, therefore it could be an eternal process. So everyone has a chance in eternity. So that moment in eternity of a lifetime, a great moment, is sleep. If we can continuously structure our mind in some form of sadhana, then it will eventually flow to the sleep cycle. And that is one of the greatest investment that nature will give us. It is nature's gift to be able to utilize those 6 hours as a form of self-development. Otherwise, it is not a good investment, isn't it? It is just a simple sleep, which is just a physiological process. But if it is invested well, if we can invest the rest of the time in the few moments of sadhana, few moments, almost regularly, every few hours, be aware of the breath, be aware of the posture, be aware of the thought patterns, and then bringing it, like last week I mentioned, that the possibility of bringing every moment as a moment of awareness. Remember that? I mentioned that every moment we are aware of what's happening, what is happening in our mind, we are learning from our mind, we are gaining clarity, we may make some errors at that moment, but we are aware, we rectify, we move on. If that happens, then it will continue into the 6 hours of so-called sleep. It is no more sleep. It is another dimension of higher practice. And this is exactly what Patanjali is talking about. So I hope that we take this opportunity. 1/3 of our lives are slept away. We don't want to waste that. And if we can give ourselves a greater motivation to practice sadhana, then that 1/3 of our time, a big chunk of our life, will become another beautiful opportunity to evolve. Namaskar, everybody. Thank you.